good video run through. I just made this interesting patch and just wanted to run through it because I like Cherry. So basically, I have my foundation, which is just my kick, snare, hi-hat, which is this second layer on the oscilloscope here. It's just BeatStep Pro with the 909 using a clap sample off of the 301 sound computer up here. Just like a static sample. I just want it to look simple, just to re-trigger every time. Also have the open hi-hats and closed hi-hats. The simple beat via this 909 module from Tip Top. And I love that thing. I like that actually. I wish there was an independent tuning for each one of them, but I like that guy a lot. Okay, I've got that. And then I've also got it. So this, I use my 4CEM3340 oscillators, and then I use my dual Baby 8 sequencer, which is being triggered via the kick and the hi-hat and snare. So there's like some multiple patterns moving the kick. So it's basically two sequences here, two sequences there. And one of them is the kick, the other is the snare. You can see every time the hi-hat moves it forward and the snare triggers it back a beat, so it's kind of off-stepping. This other one, I think, is one of the other hi-hats, and then I also have it through a clocked multiplier, so times three is kind of moving that around. Let me turn off the snare so you can just hear the chords. So that's the chords, and I ran all of them through some mixers and put them through this filter. And I have an LFO snapping that open and closed. Here it is with no envelope or LFO. Here it is with the snappiness. That'd be really nice with the delay. Shame I only have one delay. I really should get another delay for that, another for the lead. Anyway, that's the polychords through that stuff. And then I have this lead. It's just a very basic sequence for the Mother 32 going. I think I'm not even modulating the pulse. Yeah, am I modulating the cutoff? I think the cutoff is being modulated just ever so slightly by the LFO, which you can see by the rate here. It's like 9 o'clock. More extreme might be cool. I'll try that. And then I have it running through this clocked tempo delay set here. So I can kind of wash it up for some different breakdowns. And then lastly, I have this crazy bass which I made with my wavetable synth. I believe I have an LFO triggering the spectral of the waveform here, just kind of just like a way to warp the wave a little bit. And then it's a pretty consistent saw wave, which I have another saw wave down here with this LFO controlling the rate of that one. And then I have another one over here controlling the rate of this one. So this one's controlling this to speed up or down. Then that one's controlling this or this to speed up or down, which is then going to the spectral over here, which I only have, you can see the dial, that's like 2.5, like it's only like two or three little notches in the dial, almost nothing, just for some subtle movement. And then I have the output of that going to this filter, and I actually have the filter split, so you can look at it in two channels here. I have the left side, both of them, actually, I take that back, I'm sorry, this one's low pass, and this one's band pass. This one, I have an LFO going at audio rate modulation to do frequency modulation to the filter. I think it's bipolar. I'm not sure if it's unipolar. I'm pretty sure it's bipolar. And then I have another LFO actually moving the position of that. So there's FM within that range that I've set. Like, if you guys know Serum or like Massive, you can see there would be like a range around that. And the whole knob is moving up and down, as well as I have it in parallel going to this filter as well, which I have the same LFO of LFO, LFO, LFO controlling the spectral is opening and closing this filter with no FM at all. And, or actually, with the internal routing, no, there's no FM on it. Excuse me. That's if I was using FM2 on the source, because that has different internal routing that automatically carries over for whatever reason, which can be useful in some situations. Then on top of that, I have the mix of both of those signals going out, and I actually have Maths sending an LFO out to kind of bounce between this side and this side, and I kind of just like it having a little subtle balance game between the two. So here's the sound of that. And here it is all together. Let's play. Boom.